prophet. So it means that I will always get there. So when I get there, whatever God wants to use me to tell you, I'll tell you. But the Lord is ministering to me. Now look at what is happening. I saw a man. He's like you, but if you bring it to our human, you know, way of seeing things, you look far better than me. I see the person seated. As I'm talking now, he's come. Yes, I see. I see the person seated with a red polyester around him. And I see a very big pot, black. And I see the person tied the head with that red band. And I see the person doing like this. And I see the person do like this. The person do like this. The person do like this. And the Holy Spirit is ministering to me that the person has seen on a big calendar that you want to come back to Nigeria for a purpose, to do something. And it has been announced in the realms of the Spirit of your coming to Nigeria. And he says he has really prepared. And this is what is happening. The Holy Spirit is telling me, in your dream, a time will come, you feel in your spirit. You finish everything, feel in your spirit that don't go, don't go, don't go. But all the same, something will be pulling you and pulling you and pulling because he's calling your spirit into the port. That is why at times you have to pray and hear the voice of the Lord very well, because the enemy also speaks. Mm-hmm. You know the enemy speaks?
Yes.
He's calling, he's calling, he's calling, he's calling. And the Holy Spirit is telling me that when it becomes his voice and that journey, step in, your coming back is going to be very difficult. But when you hear the voice of God, whether you should go or not to go. But I'm seeing that from this time, this year might not be good for you to make any move. The time you want to go, I don't know whether you are preparing ahead of us or something to move to Nigeria to go and do something in camp. Is there something like that?
Yes,
clap on. The Holy Spirit is telling me the time and the day you want to go, let it be next year, but even don't tell anybody. Don't tell anybody. You are in a haste because he's sitting. I'm seeing him. I'm seeing him. He's doing like this. He's doing like that. Ooh. He's doing like, he's chanting. But the power of God supersedes all powers. And this is what will happen. If he doesn't get you, if you don't go on this journey, around this time, where he's looking for you, God says he's going to take a child from you.
Amen. Amen.
You understand me? Mm-hmm. Because his promise, that lesser God, that blood will come from you to them. And if you don't go for him to get that blood, then they have to demand the blood from his child.
Amen.
That's what God is going to do for you.
Amen.
Amen.
We serve a living and a mighty God here.
Amen. Amen.
When Pastor was there, he says, his thoughts concerning us is not evil. To take us to where? Unexpected end. When you seek the face of God, and God tell you that do this, even if you do it, it's not the way you like, give the glory to God. Amen. But when he says, don't, at times it can even be that you bought your ticket, you bought everything, you've made arrangement, you've called, people are waiting for you. It's better you hear the voice of God.
Amen.
This time is not good for you. It's never, no way. Good for you. They've made arrangement, they are waiting for you. But I make a decree.
Amen.
And they'll drink their own blood.
Yes.
And they will eat their own
flesh. Yes.
Since you under the power of God, and you have no other God but him alone, he who has power to see great and mighty things, who has revealed this to me, may this same God save you.
Amen.
May he save your children.
Amen.
May you not die before your time.
Amen.
May the accuser, anybody who is accusing you, may that accuser leave the scene.
Amen.
May that person be buried before his time.
Amen.
May you live to conquer. May you live to take territories and power.
Amen.
May that which your hand has done, that which you have labored for, may you live to enjoy.
Amen.
And may your destroyers be destroyed.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
Get thoughts.
I am very grateful for coming here tonight.
Hallelujah.
As a matter of fact, last month I had set a date and I went to the extent of booking a ticket. But something stopped me somewhere. I discussed that with my wife, my children, that I would be traveling.
Yes.
And I made some plans already. But something came in. And I did not actually cancel my intentions.
Uh-huh.
I did not change my plans. But I was just having it on my mind that maybe next week or then meeting. But a few days ago, I love my wife.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
God gave her to me for a purpose.
Thank you.
Yes.
She told me that I should first of all do what I have to do, and then going to Nigeria can come later on. And I thought about it. I said, okay, let me just have that in my mind and see what is going to happen. So coming here tonight has been the most important thing in my life.
Somebody's life. That's why the enemy is stopping this all night.
Mm-hmm.
And I told Pastor that, come what may. We asked for so many places and the prices they were giving us. So I even told this lady that, can't I get some people who will help with 100 so that we put our money together for the all night to come? Because I'm feeling in my spirit that God wants to deliver somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Clap unto the Lord. Bible says, don't forsake the assembling of what?
Amen.
Coming to church has never been a case. It's a blessing. But the enemy knows that the very place where you eat from and be full, he also makes sure you fight you and take you away. Even at times you can hate that place. Why? Because he knows when he leave you, you will excel. Lift your right hand. Say, no matter what,
I
will excel. Say, no matter what,
shall
dwell with me. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Who is that person? I have hearing two names and all the names are coming from myself.